Lucas on a brutal mount position, looking for ground and pound, good posture. Scott trying desperately to spin and get out of there. And Lucas is having none of it. Just pounding away. Scott's got to tie him down, doesn't he, Paul?
He definitely does. He needs to put his arms around the waist and pull him down, try and trap him down here, and he needs to look for some sort of escape here. He needs to really start to try and to control.
And they're sitting right here in front of us right now.
He needs to control what Lucas is doing there.
Lucas is just
vicious.
Absolutely. Stole the word right out of my mouth, Paul. Vicious. Good high mount here for Lucas.
Well, he's worked hard here. A lot of people think the mount, you just get on and sit on the belly button, but it's not. And that was a fantastic reversal, and Lucas has done the right thing there by getting their hooks in.
Absolutely, and taking the back. When you lose the mount, you want to spin to the back, and not lose that dominant position, reaching in.
He's going to stretch him out here and look for the pounding. He should be looking to push the hips away from him and stretch him out.
Brutal shots from Lucas. Now looking to sink in possibly a choke, although he's still looking for shots to probably open up that space, right, Paul?
He's just trying to create the space there because the position he's got at the moment could be given up at any moment here.
Possibly looking to roll him over onto his back, stretch him out further.
The hammer fist there, brutal hammer fist. Nasty. You can hear those going through.
Absolutely, pounding through
the floor. He's in big trouble here, unless he can get out of that and reverse it. He's got to watch out for the armbar now.
Yeah,
if Lucas can get his leg over, he can just push it. He hasn't secured that choke yet, but it's there. He's got it.
That's it. That's a wrap.
Beautiful.
Lovely finish from Lucas. Now 2-3 improving here.
Lucas looking very, very good there. Very dominant.
Absolutely. 5 years of training in MMA, from what I can tell here. A very clear veteran, Paul. I think that showed tonight.
Scott Mitchell, though, I mean, he done well to get in there with someone with that experience. He's only been training in a year, so take me out of to both fighters there.
Absolutely. Some brutal shots from Lucas, opening up the rear naked choke finish. Well done for both fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee stopped the contest due to a rear naked choke. And the winner from the red corner, Lucas Pitbull! Please show your appreciation for his opponent, Scott Mitchell! Well done, guys. Great fun. Fighting out of the red corner and representing Team VN and the Barbarians. This is his debut fight. Please welcome Mark Harris! Fighting out of the blue corner and representing MMA Evolution. He has a fight record of 1 loss. Please welcome into the cage, Sean Bates!
Yeah, backstage! Yes!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are for our 10th fight. Class B rules. Headshots will be allowed, except for on the ground. Two fighters here this evening. Mark Harris out of the red corner, Sean Bates out of the blue. Sean with a record of 0-1. Mark, I believe, is making his debut.
MMA debut, I believe. Chris, I've seen Mark Harris fight K1 before.
Ah, okay. Let's see if he tries to keep this fight sane. Touch the gloves and we are underway.
Oh,
beautiful right cross there. Sean wanted none of that, clinching immediately.
Sean's looking to dominate here and go for the takedown. He's looking to work his way down. Mark needs to start swimming here and that's it, he's done it. He's got a double underhooks.
Yep.
Beautiful takedown, nice straight into the mount.
And so, Paul, this man has a K-1 background?
He certainly has. Actually, Mark Harris is the K-1 champ of my fight night, which is Night of Champions.
Night of Champions, hosted in Hastings, East Sussex. Another fantastic show for you folks to check out.
There's a nice lot of pass. Action here. There's Absolutely. A lot of action here. Mark Harris has certainly been working on these ground game by the looks of it.
Very apparently. Nice tight side mount, knees in tight. Switching over there to possibly a scarf hold. Nope, not quite yet.
Not quite. He's got to watch that head there. He can transition into an arm bar. Beautiful.
Ooh, nice.
Fantastic there. He looks
no
like
arm
he
in,
out.
Though.
No arm in. But he looks but tight. That's pretty tight. Yes, over.
Wow. Fantastic. A very rare finish here, folks. Usually, when a choke is caught like that, there is an arm in between the legs. In this case, there was not. That's so, a no arm triangle from a K1 fighter.
Fantastic debut there of his MMA career by Mark Harris.
Mark Harris by submission in the first round. Very good win for him there. Very very good amount of awareness there on the ground, Paul. It seemed like he's really been working on his ground game.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee stopped the contest due to a leg triangle maneuver. The winner out of the red corner representing Team VN and the Barbarians, Mark Harris! And please show your appreciation for his opponent tonight, Sean Bates! Fighting out of the red corner and representing Norwich Kidstock. It is his debut fight. Please make some noise for Hughes Chinika! His opponent this afternoon, representing the Fighting Lions and fighting out of the blue corner. He has a record of one win. Please show your appreciation for Darren Cooper!
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are here with our 11th fight of the evening, Class C rules, and there has been a gentleman's agreement, I've just been told, from backstage to no knees, no headshots whatsoever, no knees whatsoever. Uses Janika, fighting out of Norwich Kickstop MMA, record of 0 wins, 0 losses, 0 draws, making his debut. And Darren Cooper, out of the blue corner, fighting out of Fighting Lions with a record of 1-0.
Darren Cooper, I've seen in action before, this guy's full semi-pro, and he is a bit of a brawler. Let me tell you that.
Interesting to see how he'll adapt to the rule set then, Paul.
Very well. I mean, he
both fighters throwing leg kicks here, inside and outside round kicks.
Without the headshots or the knees, it's very difficult to finish it standing up unless you're really going to give some punishing kicks to the legs. Cooper should be looking for the takedown, but being aware of his neck there because the guillotine could be coming.
Absolutely, and wisely pulling his neck out and defending very well there is Darren.
Very, very well.
Uses with a beautiful, nice right round kick there. And Darren returning.
Should be really checking there instead of trying to block them kicks with the hands.
Nice front kick.
Nice.
Catches
takedown.
High crotch and immediate takedown.
Push him to the side of the cage and dominate. There we go, mounts there.
Straight to mount. Darren Cooper on mount.
He should be looking here, Cooper, for either an arm triangle or an arm bar.
Looking to isolate that arm, possibly move to a higher mount here, although he is staying low at this point.
He's going for the armbar. He's trying to set that armbar up. You can see that there. Janika really should be pulling him down and trying to look for the reversal, maybe doing a bit of cage walking there.
Absolutely.
You can tell by Cooper's body positioning that he's trying desperately to set that armbar up.
Cooper looking left, Cooper looking right, trying to isolate that arm.
He's in a good spot, Cooper, though, because he's in his corners. He's in his own corner. He's there.
Leo Alderman giving advice.
Leo again. I know Leo really well. He's got a good camp up there, fighting Lions. They fought on many shows around.
Darren being very patient as well, not giving up position.
Should be trying to find a little bit more submissions here, maybe a little bit more body shots and a bit harder punishment to the body. He's running the risk now of Janika getting off there.
Yeah, Yuzis did seem to be the very much the taller fighter, so he has to be worried about that buck there. Yuzis trying to buck, create space, which is one technique that can be used to get an opponent off of mount.
He's giving up the arms freely, though, there. And you know, he's got to watch that because he's going to get caught. It's just a matter of time. And the referee's obviously overlooking things, and it looks like he'll be ready to stand him up shortly.
Nice transition. Oh, but no seatbelt.
Didn't have the hooks in either. You've got to get position before submission in this game.
100%, Paul. Very well spoken. Nice body kick.
Yeah. Both fighters starting to breathe now. You can see the tiredness. Nice check there. He's ready for it. He's checking well.
Uses perhaps looking to circle here, staying the outside, land some more nice kicks. Nice kick
beautiful
again.
Beautiful kick. This is one I'd love to have seen with the headshots, to be quite honest.
Definitely.
Because it looks like both guys can bang. Big charge there. He's got to watch it again, Cooper.
We should finish the round here just against the cage. Very spirited exchanges, Paul, on the feet between both fighters.
Not bad. I mean, you know, they're very game, the pair of them. I think it's very restrictive when you fight, if you're fighting at amateur level, because obviously you just can't get that one big shot that might end the fight.
No question. Although I have to say that Darren did look very experienced, being very patient on mount. Uses as well. Good composure, getting up, landing some nice kicks at the end of the round there. Tough round to score, Paul.
Very tough. Very backwards and forwards.
We are underway.
I think we're going to see leg kicks immediately here, straight off. They're going to come straight in with them. There we go.
Right on cue. Uses with a nice right round kick to the leg. Darren looking out to the audience. And returns with another right round kick of his own.
Nate has read it well. He can see that Cooper's gassing, and he's trying to keep it on his feet as long as possible. Beautiful takedown there. Bam. More like a throw, really.
Yuzis does seem very good condition here.
He's got very good cardio, and he's reading it well at Cooper. And if Cooper's not careful and don't start checking them kicks, that's going to be devastating on his legs.
Especially in the later rounds. We are only in three-minute rounds in this fight, but nonetheless, each kick does add up, does it not?
It really does, and, you know, it really will take its toll.
Nice inside leg kick. Very sneaky technique here from Darren. Once again, on cue. Yuzis returning the favor.
They've got to do something here to finish this fight. I mean, both fighters are starting to gas, and the tendency is when you gas is to keep away, but really you've got to look for the finish, especially if you can see that your opponent's gassing.
Although it is interesting to note that both fighters are trying to keep the fight standing here, Paul. The finish could take some time then.
It really could. And given on the round it was just there, I mean, you know. Good, very, very, very good control there.
Yeah, definitely. Yuzis definitely is very aware that Darren is trying to close the distance, possibly land the clinch and land another takedown.
And that will be devastating. You can see the pressures there. He's got to go in again and stop it. Bam, and it's all
over.
That's
it. Wow. Yuzis Janika making his debut here this evening at Battle of the Brawlers, finishing the fight via leg kicks.
Very, very well read. He could see his opponent was in trouble and went straight in for the finish.
Absolutely.
And again, to anybody watching, it could look quite brutal, but it's not. It's the nature of our sport. We've got to finish the fight afterwards. There's always sportsmanship.
100%. Very successful debut from Yuzis, and a very spirited performance from Darren Cooper.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee stopped the contest due to a TKO. The winner out of the red corner, Yuzis Janika. And please show your appreciation for Darren Cooper out of the blue corner. He took the fight on earlier on today. Well done, Darren. And it was a massive height and weight difference. Well done. Brilliant. Fighting out of the red corner,
representing the New Breed Club. He has a fight record of one win. Please welcome into the cage, Luis Espino!
Look, there's a chap, that means council have to run. He's got a hoodie, yo, give him a hug. A second voice, don't be the one to give him up. Oh shit, too late, that was kinda dumb. Whose idea was that? Stupid. You've got some fun, ain't we all? Be the joker, play the ball. Politics, ain't it all? Smoke and mirrors, ain't the rules. All year round, all in all. Just another brick in the wall. Get away with murder in the schools. Use four letters, where words, cause we're cool. All drinkers, drug takers. Every single one of us, off the earth. Keep going, living on your feet.
And his opponent this evening, fighting out of the MMA Evolution, he's fighting out of the blue corner. He has a record of 2 wins with 1 no contest. Please make some noise for Tony Hall!
Ladies and gentlemen, fight number 12, Luis Espino versus Tony Hall. Luis with a 1-0 record, fighting out of New Breed MMA. Tony with a record of 2-0-1, fighting out of Evolution MMA. Tony having fought before on previous Battle of the Brawlers, Paul. Same show I believe you fought on professionally.
Indeed, Chris, I did. I fought professionally and was the main event there. Fought Kanjit Deegan. Fantastic win for me.
Absolutely.
Thought I better plug that.
Tony picking up another win as well at the last show via arm lock. A very savvy submission fighter.
Lewis there coming out. He looks ready to bang.
No feeling out process. Tony looking for the tie clinch.
Tony's
really tightening that thing down.
He's looking for the tight down here.
Nice defense there by Lewis.
Lewis is doing well there. I mean, he's really doing well. I mean, he's driving them knees in there. He should be just pounding that body now, really trying to take the gas out of him, pushing his head up.
Possibly looking for a guillotine choke there. Not sure how tight that is.
These fighters ain't in the mood for messing about here.
Not whatsoever. No feeling out process. Tony and Louis grappling furiously.
Louis there, look, he's a right little tiger, Louis. You can see it, he's straight in. Tony there, not messing about, driving them big time knees up there.
A frantic pace set here very early in round one between Tony Espino and, excuse me, Luis Espino and Tony Hall.
Tony all having the reach advantage there. If he can just use that to drive them knees into the body a bit more, he could take the wind out of Lewis there. And he's going for the takedown.
Lewis very aware.
Lewis needs to open them legs wide now and not let that trip come, because them legs standing together is a recipe for disaster, and it's a matter of time before he goes out. Tony now needs to pull that leg and drive himself back to take Louis down.
And on cue, a nice double takedown here.
He looks from Tony, although pass. Tony looks like in the pass here.
Lewis was looking for a guillotine choke, but seems to have let that go. Full guard. Lewis locking up full guard here.
Tony needs to start firing some bombs down here. By the looks of it, he's looking to stand over it and finish the fight.
Lewis wisely shifting his hips, locking in head and arm control here to pull Tony down into his guard. Needs to pull him down,
control him, look for some wrist control and damage limitation, and it looks like he's reversed it. And what
wow.
A reversal straight into the mount. It could be he's got to pass that guard, but Tony all there doing a fantastic job to
retain half guard.
Beautiful,
lovely transition by that little sweep there.
Well, what Louis needs to do now is not worry about the chokes. He really needs to start pounding down and maximizing the damage that he can cause.
Tony full guard,
Hall.
Tony.
Tony Hall, got to watch it here.
Got to
watch
out for
that.
Armbar
on a triangle. Fantastic slam. And he's ground and pounding there. He's got to watch them hips again.
Tony with a very active guard.
Very, very active. He's got to watch them straight arms, and he's got to be aware of them legs going high.
Anytime an arm is in, it's in jeopardy, right,
Paul? It's very in jeopardy, but he's passed there, and he's got a fantastic little half guard there. Side control.
And nearly the end of the round.
30 seconds.
Looking for that Americana on the far side. Tony wisely using his legs, looking to try to get some sort of position here.
A lot of tiredness going on now, but that was a fantastic round by both fighters.
A very frantic pace. I wonder if conditioning might be a factor, Paul.
I think it could be a very good factor. I mean, Louis there was like a little dynamite coming out, exploding. And Tony Hill there, fantastic job by both fighters, I thought.
Definitely, Tony Hall delivering some nice knees from the clinch. Lewis, probably his best move being the sweep he hit off his back.
Great little sweep, dominated well.
Can't wait for round two, Paul.
Brilliant. Louis there breathing heavy. Tony Hall looks a little bit gassed too, but this could be a good fight. Sign of respect there, fantastic.
Vicious outside round kick from Louis. Wow, Superman jab, oh my.
It's good to see Tony trying to use his reach there and keep Louis off, but Louis, like, he is a little pit bull straight in there. He's look, what a fantastic
Lovely.
Little takedown, beautiful.
From the single to the outside trip, passing guard, half guard here.
Tony all doing the right thing there. He's looking for the guillotine. It looks like he set it up too. I just don't think it's there.
He's had to let that go.
Louis needs to just base up now, get his left elbow, push down on the head and create some space. And just drive himself up, and he really needs to push up now.
And that he's done, Paul, passing into full mount.
He's got to be careful though, because he can get switched from underneath here. Look, and he's straight out, he can transition into a knee bar, an ankle lock.
Tony Hall with a lovely scramble there, very savvy off his back.
Look, he's got to get out, straight up, bam, and he's straight on him.
Tony having none of it. Lewis having none of it.
It looks like he's sinking in the guillotine there, but it looks like the arms through.
Louis got to get that half guard as Tony's trying to cage walk here around into mount or possibly side control.
He's got the head out. I just don't think it's there, Chris, to be quite honest. I think the strength is a major conviction at this time.
And on cue, Tony does escape. Very frantic pace. I'm impressed with these guys. Really going at it.
Really, really well. Tony needs to start working now on the strikes. He needs to start dominating and showing the referee that he's trying to stop this fight so that it just don't get stood up.
Absolutely. I can hear his corner calling for that, Paul. Calling for him to posture up and land some strikes from within the guard, Tony's corner is.
And obviously, Louis there needs to pull the guard down and try and get Tony down so he can damage limitation. Cage walk there and... Very, very, very good fight, this one.
Ooh, pulling rubber guard.
Pulling rubber guard there.
Looking for possibly the omoplata or the gogoplata, but the arm isn't on the mat. You really want to try to have that right arm, Tony's right arm, on the mat in order to get that move, and it's missed.
Well, he can give it up and get passed on the guard there.
Yeah, absolutely. Or create a scramble.
Both fighters there displaying... exhaustion.
Definitely, you can see Tony breathing very hard, but he's going for that right hand, landing some shots from the guard there.
Well, he's trying to put a hand on the face there to restrict the breathing. You can see that going on, you know, and obviously create the space that he can work some strikes.
Nearly the end of the round. It looks like this may go to round three. This is Class A.
He needs to pull
three
down.
4 minute rounds. We do have a lot of time left in this match, and both fighters just going to the end. What a round, Paul.
What a round. That was a tough one to score.
Very tough indeed. Both fighters spending some time.
Very,
on
very
top
tough.
Scrambles, attempting submissions.
Louis there were having a little bit of trouble getting to his feet. I think in the next round, this could all go down to who's got the better cardio.
It could be one apiece. In this round, this next third round could be the deciding factor here. Just a beautiful round, a very frantic pace between both fighters. Can't wait for round three, Paul.
Should be a good one.
Tony Hall versus Louis Espina. What a fight we have on our hands.
It's going to be phenomenal this round.
Absolutely. Touch of gloves and we are underway.
Tony Hall looks like he's got a little bit more in the gas tank than Louis, to be quite honest.
Absolutely. Looks to be the fresher fighter here.
If he pushes the pressure here, he could finish it quite quick. Louis there, his hands are dropping, the exhaustion setting in.
Nice combination for
Tony
Hall.
He can finish this. Louis, look at the spirit of the youngster. He's firing them shots back. I mean, this is just what warriors. What a fantastic fight.
Nice left body kick there landed by Louis. He's got to put those hands up, doesn't he, Paul?
It certainly has, but when you're gassed and them hands just go down, your mind tells you what to do, but it necessarily the body just won't work.
And Tony possibly dropping for a double leg here, it looks like.
He knows he's going to take him down there to conserve some energy and obviously start working for a good position.
And it's fairly likely to say, Paul, that whoever wins this round will probably take the decision.
I'd say so. For me at this moment, Chris, I think so far this could be fight of the night for me. So far.
Absolutely, yeah. It's been a really, really good frantic pace. Both fighters giving 110% of energy here. Tony working in nearly to half guard here. Yes, he has passed a half guard and into full mount.
And this is where it could all be over now.
The same spot Tony finished his last fight with an arm lock.
And what a fantastic reversal. But he's got to watch the hips here. He's going to go high and try and submit him with the armbar.
On cue, Tony Hall locking up the armbar.
He's got to drive the hips down. Beautiful. Absolutely phenomenal.
And he's out.
He's just got to start pounding now. Fantastic. Beautiful.
Wow.
And he's got to watch them. He's got to watch it again.
Could be looking for a triangle. Tony hooking the leg.
He's hooking the leg there.
What spirit displayed here by Louis Espino, Paul.
What a fantastic fighter this youngster is.
Certainly putting New Breed MMA on the map tonight.
He's trying to secure the triangle there.
Oh, that looks deep.
It looks deep indeed. It looks like he's got
triangle it. Triangle armbar combination.
He's trying to pull out there. He's trying to get out. Can he just get out? It looks like he's out.
Wow.
He's out. Fantastic. Beautiful.
And right here in front of us, Paul. Looking for the scramble half.
Looks like Louis suffering from a little bit of exhaustion there. And Tony Hall now needs to capitalize on that mount and start ground and pounding, basically.
Tony Hall, neon belly position here in side control. Switching to full mount.
Dominating. He's got to start working for the ground and pound now to finish this fight. It's only a matter of time before this will be finished. Louis just hasn't got the strength to carry on. And
it's
all right
over. Tony Hall with a stoppage in the third round. TKO victory. What an incredible fight, Paul. Great heart from both fighters. Both fighters laying here on the floor of the ring in exhaustion. No surprise.
Absolutely fantastic. What a fight from both fighters. Absolutely brilliant.
As their corner men bring them to their feet. Round one, two, and three, all frantic, back-to-back action, non-stop, Paul.
Phenomenal.
Look forward to seeing both these guys fight again.
Will indeed.
Well, at this point, I'd like to say thank you very much to Paul Saunders from Zoo Fight Club, seasoned professional fighter, MMA coach, and all-around great guy, Paul. It's been a pleasure this evening.
Chris, it's been absolutely phenomenal. Thanks very much, my friend, and I'll catch you again soon.
Absolutely. We'll be joined by our next guest commentator after this next break. Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned.
Curry Hardpoint is really, really warm this week. There can only be one winner. From the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, Tony Hall! And please, please, show your appreciation for his opponent, very gallant fella, Luis Espino. Well done, guys.
Fighting out of the red corner, Mark A.